Good morning. In the previous lecture, we talked about internal energy. Now let us talk about Helmholtz function. Helmholtz function is taken as second thermodynamic potential. Helmholtz function is taken as second thermodynamic potential. It has dimensions of energy and it is represented by the letter capital F. So Helmholtz function capital F is given by F is equal to U minus Ts, equation number 1. Helmholtz function F is given by this equation U minus Ts, equation 1. According to first law of thermodynamics, delta Q is equal to du plus delta W. That is nothing but du plus PdV. I am going to solve each and every step, although same steps may be needed in various articles, because I want you to get all the things perfectly. Your understanding should be thorough understanding. Delta W replaced by PdV, so we got delta Q is equal to this. Keep this delta U on this side, transfer this to this side to get du is equal to delta Q minus PdV, equation number 2. According to second law of thermodynamics, dS is delta Q divided by T. This is further delta Q is equal to TdS, equation number 3. Let us substitute equation 3 into equation 2 to get du is equal to TdS minus PdV, equation number 4. Du is equal to TdS minus PdV, equation number 4. Let us suppose that this thermodynamical system undergoes infinitesimal isothermal reversible process. Let us assume that this thermodynamical system undergoes infinitesimal isothermal reversible process. If this system undergoes infinitesimal isothermal reversible process, this T will be constant. As T is constant for infinitesimal isothermal reversible process, equation 4 can be written as du is equal to डी ऑफ टी एस माइनस पी डी वी. टी इज कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर द आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस. लेट अस टेक दिस टर्म टू दिस साइड टू गेट डी यू माइनस डी ऑफ टी एस इज इक्वल टू माइनस पी डी वी. और एल एच एस में फर्दर बी रिटर्न एज डी इंटू यू माइनस टी एस इज इक्वल टू माइनस पी डी वी इज इक्वल टू माइनस डेल्टा डब्ल्यू. अकॉर्डिंग टू इक्वेशन वन यू माइनस टी एस इज एफ. हियर फॉर यू माइनस टी एस वी कैन कीप एफ एंड सो we have here df is equal to minus delta w equation number 5. So we have here df is equal to minus delta w equation number 5. What is meaning of this? Meaning of this is work done in isothermal reversible process. Work done in isothermal reversible process is due to decrease in Helmholtz function, is due to decrease in free energy of the thermodynamical system. Work done in isothermal reversible process is on expense of the Helmholtz function df, and therefore we have df is equal to minus delta w. Or I may further write df is equal to d of u minus ts. This is du minus tds minus sdt. Equation number 6. Df is equal to minus delta w. I have given interpretation for this equation. I have explained meaning of this equation. Okay, this is f, so it will be df. So I can write df is equal to d of u minus ts. If RHS is solved, we will have du minus tds minus sdt, equation number 6. But what is du according to equation 4? According to equation 4, du is tds minus pdv. So let us substitute tds minus pdv for this du in equation 6. If we do this, we will have let me write here, but du is equal to tds minus pdv, therefore df is equal to tds minus pdv minus tds minus sdt. Plus TDS, minus TDS, these two get cancelled with each other. And what left? DF, change in Helmholtz function, DF is equal to minus PDV minus SDT, equation number 7. Equation number 7. If we make dt 0, the process will be infinitesimal isothermal reversible process, and we know we will come to this result. It is already discussed. Now let me have dt is equal to 0, dv is equal to 0. Dt is equal to 0 if the process is isothermal. dv is equal to 0 if the process is isochoric. And therefore, if this thermodynamical system undergoes if this thermodynamical system undergoes isochoric, isothermal, reversible process, this term will be 0, this term will be 0, and we will have df is equal to 0, that is nothing but f is equal to constant, equation number 8. It means that whenever a thermodynamical system undergoes isochoric, isothermal, reversible process, there is no change in Helmholtz function, Helmholtz free energy of the thermodynamical system. In other words, whenever a thermodynamical system undergoes isochoric, isothermal, reversible process, Helmholtz free energy of that system remains constant. This is about Helmholtz function or Helmholtz free energy. This is taken as second thermodynamic potential. So each and every step is solved and explained. Hope you understood everything about the Helmholtz function. Thank you.